Hi guys, this is Asma Mushtaq from DWE Vibes, and in today's lecture I will explain about a very important and interesting topic of the linear algebra, that is actually basis and dimensions. In order to get the idea of the basis and dimension concept, you must have first the knowledge of what is the span of a vector space or a vector space. And second thing is, what are the linearly independent vectors? Once you are well familiar with these two things, you can easily decide what are the basis and dimensions. So let's say a set of a vector which is denoted by S, and this set of the vector actually consists of the vectors u1, u2, u3 up to so on un. Alright, and these set of vectors actually belongs to the vector space V. So they all belongs to a vector space V, such that the S span V, alright, and S is linearly independent. Then we will say that the set S is called the basis for V. So for better understanding, let's say the vectors E1, which is having the two components 1, 0, and E2, which is equal to 0, 1. Fine. Then we will say that they form the basis in R2. Why? Because we can simply check these two properties. If these two properties are satisfied, then we will say that they form the basis of R2. Since we can generate any vector having two components using these two vectors, or we can generate any vector having component x, y as a linear combination of e1 plus be2. It means what? By using the linear combination of e1 and e2, we can generate a vector that will be having the two components x and y. So let's say if x is equal to 3 and y is equal to 2, then the value of the constants will be 3, 1, 0 plus 2, 0, 1. So if you simplify this expression, you can clearly see you are going to get a vector 3 into 1, 3, then 0 plus 0, 2, and on further simplification, you can clearly see here you can generate the vector, the desired vector. Fine. In this way, you can generate any vector having two components using these two vectors e1 and e2. That's why e1 and e2 are called the standard basis of R2. Fine. Standard basis of R2. Why R2? It means the dimension, and R represent the real number. Fine. So you are going to generate the vectors having two components in real numbers. If you talk about the dimension, since two vectors are involved for generating the vectors having two components, so that's why this dimension, the dimension of this vector space is equal to 2. Similarly, the standard basis for R3 will be E1 is equal to 1, 0, 0, E2 is equal to 0, 1, 0, and E3 is equal to 0, 0, and 1. So why these are called the standard basis? Because if you want to generate any vector having three components using these three vectors, then you can simply see the x component will be the multiple of e1, the y component will be the multiple of e2, and z component will be the multiple of e3. Fine. And hence, for the n dimensional space, this standard basis will be having n components, where e1 will be equal to 1, 0, 0 up to so on, and e2 will be equal to 0, 1, 0 up to so on, and similarly en will be equal to 0, 0 up to so on nth. Hence we have simply seen the first property, that is either the given set of the vectors span in that particular space or not. Fine, the first property is satisfied. For testing this second property, you need to test either the set of the vectors are linearly independent or no. The first and the quickest way for checking either the set of the vectors are linearly independent or not is to take the determinant of the vectors that are actually spanning in the vector space V. So we have e1 is equal to 1, 0 and e2 is equal to 0, 1. If you write or in the form of the column vectors, you can see you will have 1, 0 and then 0, 1, and you are actually going to take the determinant formed by these vectors. Okay, and you can clearly see here the determinant is not equal to 0. This is very simplest way for checking either the set of the vectors are linearly independent or not. Just find out the determinant. If the determinant is not equal to 0, then these vectors are linearly independent. Okay, so we have seen e1 and e2 actually span the vector space V or span the R2. It means we can generate any vector using these two vectors having two components in real number. And second property of the linearly independence is also satisfied. Fine, they are also linearly independent. That's why we will say that these set of vectors actually form the basis of R2, form the basis in R2. Okay, for checking the linearly independence or dependence, you can also watch my lecture that is available in the playlist. Now in the next part of the lecture, I will explain or do some examples of the basis of the vector space V. Thank you for watching.